Wow, thank you. Man, what an incredible deep dive by Daniel. I think it really puts into perspective the scope of what the team has accomplished. I am here to talk to you about the Lens Developer Platform. I have been lucky enough to be part of the engineering team building Snap AR since 2016. And I heard earlier in the Q&A, a lot of you in the audience today have been on this journey for even longer than that. But regardless, if you have been building lenses for years or you are just getting started on your journey, I have one job today. And that is making absolutely sure that you walk out of here convinced that Lens Studio and lenses are the very best platform for building AR in the world. So, most people wouldn't know this, but the very first lenses that appeared on Snapchat back in 2016, they were written in C++. An engineer put them directly into the binary. Those first lenses were designed to do what lenses do best. They were fun. They helped you express yourself and live in the moment and share those experiences with friends. But the vision was always for lenses to be a platform. Internally, our organization literally was called Camera as a Platform, or CAMPLAT. So when Lens Studio 1.0 launches in 2017, it has a very unique design. It's one that enables a community of creators, both inside and outside of Snapchat, to build and publish and share AR with the world. If you'll permit me a little bit of bragging, I think we absolutely changed the face of AR development. So, we talk a ton about Lens Studio, and rightfully so. But at the heart of this platform is Lens Core. Lens Core is a powerful C++ runtime and rendering engine. It's similar to a game engine, but we say that it has AR in its DNA. So one of the things that differentiates Lens Core from a game engine is world-class scene understanding. So this lets Lens creators augment their environment from faces to pets to huge open worlds. And as the platform evolves, we extend that runtime with Lens Cloud. You know, this allows AR developers to connect Snapchatters and shared lens experiences, and it brings in new capabilities like custom landmarkers and remote assets. You know, hopefully some of you were very excited to see the launch of the leaderboard feature at SPS yesterday. I know this has been a long time coming. So, month by month and year after year, the tools keep expanding. We've added full body tracking. We add advanced animation and physics simulations. You know, in our opinion, we have launched the world's most advanced real-time ray tracing on mobile. And Lens Studio keeps evolving right along with it. You know, we gain hugely impactful developer-facing features like the material graph or the VFX editor. Then in 2021, we launch our first spectacles with displays, and we learn a lot. You know, frankly, spectacles blow us away. And for us on the developer platform side of things, we see this huge opportunity. And it was definitely time for us to rethink Lens Studio from the ground up. We continued to work really hard on the Live Lens Studio product. But at the same time, a small group was carved aside and started laying the foundations for the future. And that future would become Lens Studio 5.0. So at last year's Lens Fest, we launched Lens Studio 5.0 into beta to get the product into the hands of our early adopters. And like any beta program, our goal was to get feedback that we could act on quickly. So thank you to all of you who helped out with this. This is a huge reveal. It's an enormously proud moment for our team. And we solve a ton of real pain points for our developers. You know, things like being able to open multiple instances of Lens Studio and being able to copy and paste between projects. TypeScript support, this is an enormous step forward for the dev community. But some of you also had to be wondering why we would rewrite this entire tool from its foundations just to solve developer pain points. And we were up here on stage dying to pull back the curtain fully, but we could not. So here we are on the first day of Lens Fest and the day after SPS, the curtain has been fully pulled back. This is a tool that is sophisticated enough to power cutting-edge AR development across mobile, web, and spectacles. You know, it's a tool that's flexible enough to for designers and engineers. And it's a tool that's approachable enough for someone just getting started on their journey that can now also power teams of professionals building large-scale spatial applications. You know, of course, we have retained all of the things that made Lens Studio so popular. It's still lightning fast to test and iterate on spectacles because you don't have to wait around for anything to compile. There aren't dozens of SDKs to install. You still can publish directly from within the app. So developers in any industry can go very quickly from an idea to millions of consumers and it's still for free. We are introducing some new features that are specifically aimed just at you Spectacles developers. The biggest one is the Spectacles Interaction Kit. You know, it enables you to quickly compose interactive experiences and that are both easy to use and at the same time help maintain a consistent UX between applications. Building on top of the plugin framework in Lens Studio, we've built a set of custom plugins that will help provide thermal profiling and Perfetto logging for your lenses on specs. As a bonus, the Perfetto logging works for your mobile testing too. We've enabled customization options for the Spectacles controller, which DB Creations have used here to turn the Spectacles mobile controller into a gamepad for their Tiny Motors game. You can't do it just yet, but soon you'll be able to reskin those controllers from within Lens Studio as well. So you heard earlier, at Snap, one of the core design principles we follow is better together. With connected lenses on Spectacles, we've leveraged the Snap social graph to make sharing an AR experience with friends possible. Lens Studio now also features improved connected lens tool, connected lens simulator, which makes it easy to test those multiplayer experiences. And to help abstract some of the lower level communications protocols, we've created the Sync Framework plugin, which makes it much more straightforward for developers to synchronize objects in shared spaces. In much the same way that building lenses for Snapchat has felt for years, building lenses for Spectacles feels like a first class experience. And I don't think that there's another experience like it. But I don't want you to take my word for it. I definitely encourage you all to see for yourselves. There are so many incredible sessions at LensFest this year. I really recommend that you take advantage of as many as you can. Working with Spectacles and Lens Studio is honestly just so cool. All right, I want to take a step back for a second and try to put some of this in a wider context. You know, what does a lens do? It changes how you see the world, right? So years ago, we named our AR applications lenses, and as a camera company, we felt very clever about this. But lenses have evolved to be so much more than just bending light. You know, as a file format, lenses are powerful. They are lightweight, and they can run in real time across any device without you needing to export to different file types. You know, remember, build once, run everywhere. And because we have spent years laying the groundwork for lenses as a development framework, and not just as filters, we're ready now to welcome the future of spatial computing on a familiar platform with a familiar community. Think back on the introduction of SnapML in Lens Studio. This was groundbreaking. You know, it's a cliche, but it really did open up a whole new world of opportunities. And yes, we've continued to improve this product. You know, over time, we've made it much easier to train those models. You know, in some cases, all you have to do now is type a prompt. But the original foundations are still there. And on Spectacles, real-time custom ML object trackers bring out the true magic of AR. When you can accurately detect, track, and augment the real world, and not a camera feed of the real world, with no visible lag, this is when you are truly blurring the line between physical and virtual. So another piece of the foundations that we have laid more recently are plugins and custom components. We knew that we could not build an engine that would be the absolute best tool for everybody without allowing everybody to build. But the part that I'm super excited about is seeing you all share your custom components and plugins with each other, because this is how a developer ecosystem thrives, and it builds momentums and gains efficiencies. So many of you already know Max van Leeuwen, of course. He built, yes. He built WireTool. This is a great library. It lets you create continuous geometry for things like streaks and trails. But the real magic happens when you combine capabilities like using hand tracking to lay the points for the trails, and then apply materials like to bring vines or spider webs or tubes to life. And by the way, the flower paint tool, or the flower paint lens that you see here was designed on mobile and worked out of the box on Spectacles. So another great example is Paper Triangles. This is an AR ad agency that's been with us for many, many years. And they have built a plugin to help their team of 20 work more efficiently. Now all they have to do is right-click on an object in the scene hierarchy and toggle on lazy loading, and now their lenses are rendering more efficiently. You know, this is critical for performance on Snapchat, and we know that this is critical for successful ad campaigns. Okay, one last one here. Through our partnership with Figma, in just a few clicks, developers can bring 2D design files into a 3D scene for near instant lens creation. You know, one of the more powerful aspects of the plugin system is this ability to work with assets. You know, this unlocks new tools for asset creation. And actually, most of the GenAI suite, this was built as plugins from our internal development team. So with custom components and plugins and SnapML, we're future-proofing the platform for wearable AR and all of the development that happens in between. The SnapAR platform has reached this incredible inflection point where the foundations are empowering tools which are combining together in ways that really do feel endless. And these endless possibilities are manifesting as daily realities for more than 300 million people. So if you want to reach this audience, it's easy. Please bring your imagination, build things that nobody has built before, and share those things across mobile, web, and spectacles. This is all part of one integrated developer ecosystem. It's an unparalleled developer experience. It's been an absolute pleasure to work on. And like everybody who has helped to bring these tools to you, I cannot wait to see what you do with it. So I think we're gonna take a quick break before welcoming Karen back, so thank you.